Hello, hello, and welcome back to Agrarian Skies, episode 30, where I will hopefully be making some progress on the, what do they call them? The blood bricks, the large bloodstone bricks. So, as you'll recall from, I think it was episode before last, I needed to get some mobs to spawn and use the bound blade to, get them. But I'm having trouble with mob spawning. I think it's because I'm staying too close to the spawning chambers. So I think this area here is just too close. I've turned off these grinders, and you can see plenty of red in there, but I'm not getting anything. I mean, with these grinders turned off, let me make sure they're actually off. Right. I mean, these things are full of power. They're totally idle. There's no work to do, which means there's nothing showing up in here. So, I built this chamber back here, and what I did is used some cursed earth that I got from a quest reward earlier. That massively increases the spawn rate and reduces the distance issues to basically zero. So when I turn the lights off, I'm gonna go ahead and turn that blade on. I should start getting spawns basically immediately. Okay, I'm not kidding. Like, when I tested this just before I started recording, it worked fine. Ah, there he is. Ah! Yeah, this is why I really should not, yay, jetpacks. Alright, so you can see, start getting spawns. And, I did that for a little bit just to make sure it was working properly, and got some of the blood shards that I needed. So, I'm going to head back, put this... There we go. Put that back in the bound tool rack, and head up to make the various things that I need. So, let's look. We're going to need 4 bloodstone bricks. We also need 4 bloodstone bricks for the next level of altar. We get 32 from 1 stone and 1 weak shard. So, yeah. In fact, let me just grab this crafting table. Not really using it anymore. Okay. Can put it there. You know what? I forgot to get the stone. One shard. Grab the crafting table. And there we are. 32 large bloodstone bricks. So we can submit those. Get our potion. We got a regeneration, a yellow heart canister, and we already have plenty of those. And what else do we get? Well, a heart. Okay, good stuff. So the next thing we need to do, if we take our divination sigil, the altar, it's a tier 3 altar. So that's 1, this level is 2, this level's 3 because it's complete. We've actually got all the runes in to make the next altar, but we do not have these things. At least I think it's the large bloodstone bricks that I need. I'm hoping. And now, we click on it, and it is a tier 4 altar. Yay! Good stuff. So if we check that out, we've got that. What else do we want to do? There was an orb that we had to use a tier 4 altar to make. So we've got the Magician's Blood Orb. That required a tier 3 altar. The Master Blood Orb requires another weak blood shard, 40,000 LP, and a tier 4 altar. So, let's build it. I'm going to turn up the villager spawner and burn through this. What's the current capacity of this? 16,000. And the villagers get a certain amount. So I'm going to work through that and I will be back. I'll let it get started first. Okay, there we go. So each villager gives me 8,800. So running the math, how much do I need again? 40,000. Gonna need 5? Yeah. So we'll take that to me and then start filling up the network. So we're at 104, 110. Yeah, so yay. My capacity is still only 16,000. So, I'm gonna clean this up. I'm not quite sure how many villagers managed to spawn in here. Now, I saw an idea. I'm gonna have to get some more cursed earth to make this work, but a way to set up the area underneath with witches that would basically mean I don't have to spawn villagers anymore and sacrifice them to dark magic. Just because that, you know, seems bad. Snack time. Sorry, villagers. I wish there was a way I could just make you despawn, but you sitting here going, huh, will kind of irritate me. Our Master Blood Orb. So we've got only one left, right? The Archmage's Blood Orb, which needs a Demon Blood Shard. I'm gonna have to remember how to get a Demon Blood Shard. Maybe. We'll see. Let's toss that back in there. And oh, the Divination Sigil. Hey, what's next? So, we still need to work on our alchemical construct, and if we take a look at Ophthalmicon. It's over here. The Akamo construct is greatwood planks. To get greatwood planks, we need a greatwood sapling. To get a greatwood sapling, we need to do some infusion crafting. So I did some additional research with, was it under alchemy? Oh, that was not it. Artifice, perhaps. Yes, here we go. So I had to research a couple through here to get infusion to come up. We basically need to build an arcane workbench, build all kinds of things. Arcane pedestal, a runic matrix, and put together a multi-block to do infusion crafting to make this work. Because after we do that, then we can, we need to get 10 of those two things that are flashing, the magic wand and the acorn, to purchase this, but it's an infusion crafting. So let's go get those things that we need. So we need 10 precantatio, which is vacuous, and the lightning bolt. Of those, and 10 of the acorn. And I'm not remembering granum, which is the heart and the ordo. We have 4, so we need 6 more. Ooh, we need to make some more victus, which is water and mountains. That. Let's see, we're trying to make acorns. Granum, and we need ordo. Perfect. So now we can purchase the greatwood, sky alchemy transmutation greatwood. And so, yeah, you do an arcane infusion with a jungle sapling, witch water, shimmer leaf, cinder pearl, and a whole bunch of I'm losing the name of it right now. The stuff that you put in these things. Yeah, it's gonna bug me. What's it called? Essentia. Alright, so let's go build it. We need 4 arcane stone blocks, shards, and ender pearls. The arcane stone blocks are made with a shard, stone, and a little bit of. So if we need 4. Then we're going to need a whole bunch of these. We're going to need, let's see. 1, 2. I think we're going to need 8 of these, so 4 makings of this. 7, 4, 28. Plus 4. 32. 43 of them, if my math is correct. So yeah. We need to make 5 times this. So let's go get some shards. Okay, so we need. I think I clicked one too many times. Okay, we need four for the multi-block. Maybe I didn't. Need another shard. Four more shards. Oh, you know what? Have more order shards. And an ender pearl. Wow, we're really running out of ender pearls. And there's our runic matrix. So, let's read how to build this. We want to build. Oh, I didn't do the arcane stone bricks. I need four more blocks. Need four bricks. Of course. Oh, I already had the stone. Okay. I thought I needed more than that. Oh well. Here we go. We need to put one of these pedestals in the middle, stone bricks on top, next level of stone bricks, and then this guy goes on top. Then you basically smack the thing with the wand that needs 25 of each. So let's make sure we've got that. We do. And we're going to need a big area to do this in, because, let's figure out how many spaces we actually need. It needs a 3x3 minimum, then we need an area for the pedestals to go around the outside, so a 4x4. And then I'd like to have a place to walk, so let's make it a 5x5. Okay. And what am I missing? No idea. Alright, we're going to make it a 5x5, so our 3x3 starts here. We will start with the bricks. We'll set down the pedestal. We'll put this guy on top. We needed extra blocks just to get that in place, and I think that's right. So it should look like that, and then we'll put more pedestals around to hold the things that we're going to need to use for crafting. Cool. So when I right click, it became multi-block, which says, hey, you did it right. Awesome. So, a lot of times I've seen the pedestals go in a couple different places. I'm going to try something a little different this time. Usually I put my pedestal. That's not a pedestal. I've tried putting my pedestals here and here all the way around. It's not quite enough pedestals, honestly, for some of the things. And I'd like to make it symmetrical because that's supposed to make it more stable. So I'm going to do it like this. Where you've got eight pedestals around, you've got clear access into the middle if you need it, all kinds of fun. The other thing I'm going to do, just for my own sanity, is make a trench. And the reason for that is in case any of the unstable goo, I don't remember the name of it, but in case any of that unstable goo pops out, it will get caught right there. And I'm not going to leave this open. I'm going to fill it back in with the decorative, the edge stone bricks. It's probably easier if I do this while actually standing on the blocks. Right, now all we need to do is light it up again. Does that give us enough light? Not quite. We definitely want plenty of light. Alright, so there is our infusion altar. Got a little bit of extra material here. It's okay. Oh, I had two stone blocks already. Oh well. So let's try infusing something. Like maybe, I don't know, greatwood sapling? That'd be kind of good. Oh, wait a minute, that was actually over here. And sky alchemy. So, to make the greatwood sapling, we're going to need 6 buckets of witch water, a cinder pearl, and a shimmer leaf. And a whole bunch of stuff there. The cinder pearl is a flower with herba, ignis, permutatio, and praecantatio. So let's get some flowers and see if we can make that happen. Oh, I wanted the cinder pearl first. So, 4 herba. 4 ignis, 4 permutatio, 4 praecantatio. To get this, we really need to boil down some things. So we can get praecantatio from netherwort. Herba. Do we already have some? No, we do not. Ignis, we do have some. And permutatio. We do not. So let's go figure out what we can cook down in the crucible to make those happen. See, herba. Looks like we get get it from netherwort. Let's go look at netherwort because I think it can be get the praecantatio too. Netherwort is herba and praecantatio. So let's make a couple warded jars of those real quick. So that will cook down to make the shimmer leaf. We need the same thing with venom, which we have some, so that'll be good. We're getting the herbal, we're getting the precantatio. We still need the permutatio. Is that copper? Let's look. Yep. So we'll burn down a stack of that next. We're gonna need 4 warded jars for that. I'm gonna need some more paper. So jar labels. Ink, slime ball, and 4 paper. Ooh, I don't have any slime balls. Get some congealed green slime. Wonder if I can knock down this slime tree to get that and get a sapling back. Let's get a crook in case that gives me a better chance of getting saplings. So, no saplings, but we did get our slime balls, and I believe I've got a sapling right here. Fortunately, I'll have to work out how to get slimy saplings. That in like that, and now we have 40 jar labels. Yay. Now let's see how this is going. All full, excellent. Now let's burn down the copper, and let's see, we're going to need those warded jars. So the copper is going to have 1 permutatio and 3 metallums per ingot. So if we burn down a stack, we're going to get 3 jars full of metallum, which is fine. next thing we're going to need is some of these glass vials. Because I don't really want to toss an entire 64 of that in there. We really just want 4. A vial gives you 8, so it works out. So if we get a vial of precantatio, let's see. I'm going to need that. I'm going to need that. One of precantatio, one of herba, one of ignis, and one of permutatio. So I've got each of the elements. We've got 8 of each, means we need 2 flowers. Toss it all in the crucible. We should get 2 cinder pearls. Let's see. And 2 cinder pearls. Excellent. So next up, we're going to need to do something very similar with shimmer leaf. We need herba, permutatio, percantatio, and venom with roses. So let's get our roses. And then we'll get our, let's see. It's precantatio, herba, venom, and permutatio. Yep. So and there's our shimmer leaf. So, very cool. Oh, that one's done. Just make sure we don't have anything appearing up there. Files back in here. Next, we need 6 buckets of witch water. So let's go get that. I'm going to go ahead and put 1 shimmer. You know what? I'm going to keep all my shimmer leaf on me. Probably going to get a few more buckets of witch water, too. There we go. Let's get a drum. I'll show you why in a second. Alright, so witch water is full. Oh, that is not what I intended. Why am I getting... How am I getting water in there? That's not right. Okay, well, that was not expected, but okay. Try that again. Okay, now we're getting more witch water. Great. So what I'm going to do is just take the drum of witch water upstairs. Toss it right there. In case I need it. So, we need to put down 6 buckets of witch water. Cinder pearl and a shimmer leaf. Great, great. And then we need a. Oh, wait a minute. I don't have any of this stuff ready. Alright, I'm going to have to go get some of that stuff, and that might take a few minutes. 64 air. I don't have any air. Let's see what we can burn down sugar for. Herba, aqua, and air. Okay. That'll be next. So I'm gonna go through and work on that. That'll get my air. We're going to need. I'll get my aqua as well. We're going to need a lot of arbor. Arbor. Probably just oak wood. Let's see. Oak planks, for some reason, are not scanned, which seems very odd. So one arbor there, 4 arbor there, so functionally the same thing. We're going to need, 128 of that? So, yeah, a stack of oak wood would be fine. We're going to need Ignis, which we've got. We're going to need Ordo, Perdito, and Terra. Ordo, looks like maybe lead. Also smooth stand, so oh, it gives me the Terra too. Okay, what else? Does it also give me the Perdita? It does. So, okay, I'm going to have to burn down those, get them into essential jars, and I will be back after that. Oh, you know what? I am going to run right into that torch if I stack them there. What am I going to make the stack? Like that. Thank you. have space behind them. Yeah, that'll work. Okay, I'm going to do that, and we'll be back shortly. Why? Ah, I've got some up there. Yeah, I'm gonna have to work on that. There we go. Now my limbic's empty. Alright, so I'm gonna cook those down, and we'll be back shortly with hopefully all the stuff. Back in a bit. Alright, we are just about done cooking all the stuff that we need. So I'm just gonna let that last bit of arbor finish up. And we'll get started. So one of the things I'm doing is kind of preserving everything, you know, getting my inventory cleared out. That way if I have problems and things happen, I don't lose very much. Alright, that's a full can. Everything's empty. The other thing I did was get rid of all these essence jars of Essentia hanging out and put them in a filing cabinet because, you know, let's use the blocks that are available. Alright, so we have our Thaumium Bossed Silverwood Wand. Let's see what we have for Sky Alchemy. We're going to need 6 witch water buckets. We're going to need a shimmer leaf, a cinder pearl, a jungle sapling in the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I don't have my jetpack on. I put my thaumaturge robes on. Got all that. Jungle sapling in the middle. Very good. Now we need 64 air, 64 agua. Aqua? Yeah. Okay. 64 air, 64 water. Air. Water. And I'm going to put these down there. Seems like a reasonable use for the space. 4 jars of arbor, an ignis, and an ordo. Four jars of that, a full jar of Ignis, I thought I had Ordo, there we go, full jar of Ordo, Perdito, and a Terra. There's a Terra. And a Perdito. Alright, so we've got a ton of Essentia hanging out here. Now, the other thing I was reading about is making this a little more stable by putting magic candles, which you get making magic tallow with precantatio and rotten flesh, and then stringing them together like so. So I thought I'd do that real quick. We need 2 precantatio, which means a file will give us 4 makings. This is the part I don't like about the filing cabinet plan. I have to Get it out like that. Put it back in. Alright, so now we've got magic tallow. And then we take, we just need string. What happened to my string? Oh, I bet it's being used for fertilizer. I kind of want one more string before I do this. Let's go get some more cotton. All right. Hopefully that'll be enough. Got some more white tallow candles that we can then pop up symmetrically around the infusion altar. Hopefully make it a little bit more stable, I suppose. And then just for giggles, I'll put the other two right there. So, let's get this party started. I've got a shimmer leaf and a cinder pearl waiting here in case these two get knocked off. And let me get another bucket of witch water. Just in case. Alright. So now I'm going to walk up and right-click that thing with my wand. And what we can see is it's now drawing arbor from around it. Now I'm going to keep an eye on kind of all the things on the pedestals and make sure nothing gets knocked off. It's got to absorb all of the essentia that it needs, and then it's going to absorb the other things on the pedestals. Oh, got something going on. That, I just lost... bucket of witch water. It's okay. Oh, got me some lightning there. Oh, another bucket of witch water gone. It's okay. For some reason, I'm not able to... lost something. I'm not quite sure what yet, but it was probably important. Let's see, it looks like it was the shimmer leaf. Or no. No, it was witch water. So when I start to see witch water pulled in, I will have to make sure to put another one on it. I don't really enjoy infusion crafting, by the way. Just because of this tendency for things to explode and make a mess. Still got most of my pieces in place. That is not what I wanted. Oh! I messed that up and totally ruined the infusion. That is so irritating, because now, yeah, it's broken. Ah! Oh, that is irritating. Alright, well, let's clean it up and do it again. Witch water. And that was my own fault. I was trying to get cute and clean it up as we were going, and managed to totally screw up my infusion. Irritating. Goodness. Alright, so I've got 6 witch waters. I've got my shimmer leaf, my cinder pearl. There's the jungle sapling. Uh-oh. Well, That could have been bad, because I'm not wearing a jetpack right now, and that obviously hurt a lot. So let's try to very carefully come back up here and not fall in a hole and eat something, so that I can try to gain back some of that health. In fact, let's find a red heart to eat, and some toast. Alright. And because the robes clearly were not helpful, let's put the jetpack back on, shall we? Yeah, I think that'll work better. Okay, that was exciting. Alright, let's see what we've got. So we've still got all of our Perdido, Arbor is, I've got 1 jar of what I need, Ignis is empty, Arbor is empty, Terra is empty, Air is empty. Ordo is available. That's another empty arbor. That's a full arbor. So I need to get aqua refilled, air refilled, arbor refilled. Yeah, I'm gonna go refill these and be back. Right, let's try this again. Now with the jetpack on, let's just make sure I've got the Terra, the Ignis, 1, 2, 3, 4 trees, Ordo, Predito, Aqua, air. Six witch waters, a shimmer leaf, a cinder pearl. Yep, we're good. Okay. Let's try this again and try not to mess it up, you know, my own self this time. Alright. Just gonna keep an eye on everything again. And, I would really, really like to end this episode with a greatwood sapling. I think that would be awesome, if we don't, you know, lose too much. We lost a witch water there, but, it's okay. I'll just toss another witch water on when I'm, putting... Oh, there went a, shimmer leaf. That back. Oh, we lost something else. That'd be another witch water. I still need to add one more to it while everything is running. But I have a spare, so that's okay. But I only had one spare, so hopefully we won't run out of anything. That did not look good. I'm going to assume we need another witch water, and... get some more witch water, shall we? Okay, looks like nothing bad happened while I was away, which is good. Shimmerleaf and Cinder Pearl are still hanging out. I'm still down one witch water, which I can't replace because I don't think I can replace it. Nope, looks like I can. Okay, well that's good. And it's shooting lightning at me. Great, great. Still feeding in Sencha. Very good. I'm not overly concerned about it. The same red, yellow, and green hearts that let me survive a fall all the way down to the level 0 platform means that lightning is not a huge deal for health. I'm just really trying to keep an eye on it. This is the point that I screwed it up myself last time by pulling the jungle wood sapling off the center pedestal. So we've just got to get the last little bits of things absorbed. And hopefully it will work out. Just making sure I've still got 6 buckets of witch water, the shimmer leaf and the cinder pearl. Almost to the point of being able to absorb them. As soon as all the essentia gets in, it will start pulling in the things from the pedestals. That's when they really have to be there, when it starts looking. Oh, lost another witch water. Okay, there goes one witch water. Witch water. Shimmer leaf. Oh. Lost one. Fifth witch water. Sun pearl. The last witch water. And I have a greatwood sapling, which is awesome. We'll retrieve my buckets, clean up on aisle 4 with some of this purple gunk all over everything. I'll deal with that in a minute, but I'm very excited to be able to say, let's see, you're a wizard, Steve. I have to manually submit the sapling and then I'll get another one. So that works. And I'm going to get a green heart canister because, you know, reasons. There we go. Give myself another heart, a greater reward bag, which has instant health potion. Not a terrible potion to have. Toss that in. And now I have silverwood and greatwood. While I was in between episodes, or in between recording and trying to get everything gathered, I built this platform over here. If you look, it is in a magical forest biome. So my intent is, if I plant a silverwood there and a greatwood, you know, sort of there, they ought to grow in a little bit. And just for fun, I'll plant a shimmer leaf and a cinder pearl. See what happens. Alright. So, that is very cool. I'm pleased to have that infusion crafting behind me because, as I mentioned, I don't like infusion crafting. It's messy. Alright, so I'm going to go clean that up in between episodes, and next time, hopefully I'll be able to finish the alchemical construct centrifuge and get towards some golemancy, which would be neat. And I think that's going to do it. Thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it, and see you next time.